People say, Tim, yo, you're my hero. How you do it? How you stay strong? Let them all know.
Good evening. We're back again on the Tim and Radio broadcast of the Stone Souls to Christ Radio Show. Your host tonight, as always, Pastor Brenda D. Wilson, bringing us another word on this midweek. I say it's hump day, but we thank God for the fill-up that we get ready to get. So tune in and hit that share button across social media. Invite somebody in every Wednesday night, 8 o'clock p.m. Eastern Standard Time and 7 o'clock Central. So let's get on and give the woman of God a great big hand clap. Thank you.
Good evening. Welcome to Restoring Souls to Christ Radio Show. I am your host on this evening, Minister Jacqueline Torian, bringing greetings to you all from Roxburgh, North Carolina. I would like to first thank my Almighty God, who is my creator, for giving me life, health, and strength on today and allow me to see a day that I had never seen before. And I want to thank also Pastor Brenda Doughty Wilson, which is the creator of Restoring Souls to Christ. Also, I want to give a shout out and a thanks to Pastor Nino Ackridge and the TMA broadcast for doing what he do best, and that is control the airways and to get the word and the much needed word out there across the airways nationwide. I commend you. Kudos to you. God bless you and bid you Godspeed. Pastor Nino, keep on doing what you do. God bless you. Also, before I get started with the word on this evening, we will go into the words of prayer. Thank you, God, Father. Thank you, Holy Jesus. Hallelujah. Thank you, Father God. Oh, God, our precious name of Jesus. I just want to say thank you. I thank you, Father God, for just being an awesome God. Thank you for waking us up this morning, Father God, allowing us to go about our daily activities. Father God, thank you for this evening, Father God. Thank you for just a lot for that word that you're going to pour it into me to give to your people on this evening, Father God. Let it be a radical word. Let it be an awesome word. Let it be a rhema word from you, Father God, in Jesus' name. Let your Holy Spirit come forth. Let your anointing fall fresh. Father God, touch every person and every listener on this airway, on this line this evening, Father God. Let them hear the words that come out of my mouth, Father God. Let them be receivers of the word. Let them be doers of the word, Father. Let them listen with their heart, Father God. Not with just the ears. Let them be not with just the ears, but with their heart as well, Father God. Touch their minds and their spirit, Father God, that we be all come together and touch and agree on one accord in Jesus' name. Father God, let the words of my mouth and the meditation of my heart be acceptable in thy sight, O Lord, thy strength and thy redeemer. In Jesus' name, I pray. Amen and amen. On this evening, we are coming out of John, the 11th chapter, the 1st through the 44th verse. I will not be reading this chapter. That you can read that later on your own time. But I will be getting verses out of the chapter throughout the message. And this is the story about Lazarus, Mary, and Martha. And the topic on this evening is called Radical Faith. Radical Faith. Now, everything we're dealing with and all the issues that we are confronting right now has everything in this world to do with where you are in your faith walk with God. That doesn't mean if you're going through trouble, that is a sign that you don't have faith. It might not be the lack of faith that got you into it, but it's the strength of your faith that's going to get you through it. So when we began to look at this particular chapter in John, there are several things I want to address. We all know the story of Lazarus and his two sisters, Mary and Martha. I want to address the exit strategy that brought them out of their crisis and brought them back to their faith. I'm going to use it as a backdrop to strengthen your understanding about faith. I'm going to give you about 5 points that is relevant to and about faith so that you can understand what is necessary and you can come out more than a conqueror through him that has loved us. Amen. The very fact that we have so much detail about Mary, Martha, and Lazarus, there are things that God wants us to know. He does not start with this story with Lazarus being sick. The story starts with Lazarus being in a relationship with Jesus. Not only was Lazarus in a relationship with Jesus, Jesus had a relationship with Mary and Martha as well. The first point I want to address is relationship. Number one is relationship. I've seen too many people who are trying to exercise their faith who do not have a relationship with God. The only time they come to God is when they're in dire need or when perilous times hit. Then they look to him, get them out of the crisis they're in. They have not a foundation of their faith. They are just using God whenever they're in trouble. Now here it is, you trying to get God to do things for you, and you don't even speak to him. You don't even talk to him. You don't worship him. You don't serve him. You don't live for him. You don't seek him. And then in time of trouble, you show up talking about, hey, God, get me out of this mess. But if he doesn't do anything for you, you got the nerve to get an attitude. But I'm here to tell you that miracles begin with relationship. Relationship. And Mary and Martha sent for Jesus, and he didn't come. And Lazarus died. Sometimes when we're waiting on God, stuff dies. What you do when you've done everything you can and how you could do it, and then who knows? Maybe you might have an eviction notice, or your light bill is past due and you need to pay that cutoff payment, or your car payment is due, or your mortgage is due. Oh, and then all of a sudden, something bad happens. It gets worse. You go into stage of release. That's point number two. Release, number two, release. Release is a stage where you simply what? Let it go. You done everything you can do and that you know how to do. You done prayed and he didn't fix it. And you can't fix it. So here it is. You release it. You turn it over. You're through with it. You must understand that release is important for radical faith. For as long as you're holding on to your problem or situation, God is not going to touch it. As long as you think you can handle it, you are not eligible to receive the miracle working power of God. You find yourself in a position where you just release it and turn it over to God. You done everything. Ran out of money, all the resources, so you just release it. That's what they did with Lazarus. They said they can't heal him. They can't fix him. They prayed about him. He got worse. So Mary and Martha, they released it over to Jesus, to God. Their release was by burying him in a tomb. Whenever we have a problem we can't fix, we bury it Yes, we do. We bury it. Will it be in our back of our mind, subconsciously, or even corner of our heart? We still bury it. Point number three, roll the stone in front of it. Roll the stone in front of it. That's point number three. You have to roll the stone in front of your problem. That's how you manage the messes you cannot fix. By rolling the stone in front of it, you managing your mess that you can't fix. You putting a stone in front of it. Basically, it's a cover up. We all have covered up some stuff in our lives, especially when you done all you could and all you knew how to do with every situation. You still not stinking, and your stuff is still stinking. So guess what? You cover it up. Then when Jesus arrived in the village, now, Lazarus had been laid in that tomb for 4 days. And when Martha heard that Jesus was coming, and she came up to him, and she said, "Jesus, if you just been here, my brother wouldn't have died." So Jesus spoke to her and told her that Lazarus will rise again. Yes, he did. He told her that. So in John 11, 24 through 27, it says that the NIV version, Martha answered, "I know he will rise again in the resurrection at the last day." And Jesus said to her, "I am the resurrection and the life. He who believes in me will live, even though he dies. And whoever lives, believes in me, will never die. Do you believe this?" Martha replied and said, "I believe that you are the Christ, the Son of God, who was to come into the world." Amen. Amen. The story continues on to where Martha went back to Mary, and she told her sister Mary that Jesus was here. Mary got up. She was so grief-stricken. I can picture her in my mind as I was reading this particular scripture. She ran up to Jesus, and even though she was grieving, even though I know she had to be a little bit angry, I know that she had to be just a little bit angry, but even though she had all these emotions going through her, she fell at his feet. Mary did. She gave him reverence. And she said to him, "If you'd just been here, my brother would not have died." And she wept. Jesus' spirit was moved. It was touched. And it says in the scripture that Jesus wept as well. Now, we're going to get to point number four, revelation. During the time while he was consoling Mary and Martha and doing that grief, there was a crowd that was gathering up that was following around Mary as she was going to the tomb to meet Jesus. And with the things that Mary said to Jesus, and Martha, I can picture that Martha was just backing up. "Yeah, if he had just been here, my brother would have been living." But all of a sudden, Martha had a revelation. Yes, she did. "Even now, he's got the power to raise him up again." That's what I'm talking about. It's called radical faith. Yeah, it's bad. Yeah, it's dead. Yes, it's stinking. But even now, there's someone out there that God wants to give you an even now miracle. You've done everything you know how to do. You tried everything that you could, but failed. But it's not too late for God. Even now, I still believe in God. I still believe he's going to do something for my children. I still believe God is going to save my family. I still believe in God, period. Hallelujah. Radical faith. Even now, I still believe that he has the power to raise him up again. Even now, I still believe that my second half of my life is going to be better than my first half. I still believe that the best is yet to come. I still believe that I'm going to be the head and not the tail. I still believe. I'm here to tell you that I have a God who is able to do exceedingly and abundantly above all. The challenge of a believer is take the faith that you get in here and take it to the place out there. But the word I'm giving you, you take that to the place where you gave up. And that's release, where you released it, where you buried it. Amen. Now, that's the hardest thing in the world to do. Think about this. There is a peace in quitting due to not wanting the pain of expectation. And sometimes it feels good to quit. You even resolve in your mind that things are not going to get any better. Then you hear a word, and the word that is given kind of bothers you a little bit because you don't want to put that message on that thing that you done buried, that you done released. You don't want to stir it up again and have to go through those feelings again. Finally, Jesus says, show me where you laid Lazarus to rest. Now, when he said, show me where you laid Lazarus to rest, the stone you roll over it to close it, you got to roll it back. Amen. Amen. The stone that you roll over to close it, you got to roll it back. Now it comes to the last point. Point number five, restoration. God can't restore it if you're not willing to roll it back. That stone that you roll in front of it, to keep it from being in there, you just roll stone in front of it to cover it up. The stone you roll in front of, God can't restore you if you're not willing to roll it back. Roll that stone back on that stinky stuff. It takes some radical faith to roll a stone away on your issue. And you'll never get restoration unless you're willing to confront the stinky stuff in your life. So here they are out here in front of the stinky stuff. And they roll the stone away. By now, Lazarus stinks. So now you got to take the word that you got in here, lead it to the place where you buried your issue. Now, I can't do it for you. You have to do it for yourself. You have to do it for yourself in order to be in position to be restored by God. And that ain't easy. You got to uncover that scab and confront that issue. They brought Jesus down to that tomb, and it comes down to restoration. All right. Now, here we go. Now, what God wants us to do is what God wants to do for us is to restore the years that the cankerworm and the pommel worm and the locust ate up. God wants to give you back what life took from you. I came to tell you that God is going to restore what you lost. If you can get the courage to confront the stinky stuff, God is going to restore you. Now, Lazarus, back at Lazarus' tomb, the stone is rolled away. Jesus thought, you know, I picture this in my mind. He had so much power that God has placed on him, healing the sick and the blind throughout the lands. I got to thinking in my mind, I said, God could have thought Lazarus up out of that grave. He could have thought him out that grave. See, because he said, standing in front of that tomb, he said, Father, I know you hear me. In John 11 and 41, he said, Father, I know you hear me. And I'm just paraphrasing now. But for the benefit for all the doubters and the haters that don't believe I can do it and what I've been called to do, he first called out Lazarus' name. Lazarus. There is pure silence in that tomb. Jesus doesn't go in the tomb. He don't throw no oil in the tomb. So he called out Lazarus again, the second time. The people listened. They listened real hard. You see, there is a part of faith. When you start moving in faith, you have to have a loud, radical faith that stands up in screaming silence. Silence screams when you are waiting to hear something. You don't hear no good news at all. You out there on a limb. You have a bunch of pent-up nervous energy. Silence just screams at you. So Jesus called Lazarus the third time. And all of a sudden, there was a loud thump. And it thumped again. Everyone was waiting outside the tomb. They heard something, but they hadn't seen anything. In faith, you are not walking by sight, but by faith. And I came to tell the devil, I haven't seen anything yet, but I hear a sound. The rising of Lazarus from the dead. Here comes Lazarus out of that tomb. His hands and feet are tied. But he heard a voice calling him. And he said, I'm coming out. Jesus started working his way. Lazarus started working his way out of the tomb. There may be something you thought you lost. There may be something that you thought you lost and you rolled a stone in front of it. Something you thought was gone and everything. But you know what? Eyes have not seen, nor ears have heard. Not heard. God got a blessing coming for you. Now, in closing, I want to say this to you. There are people in this world today, and with this pandemic going on, and with the crisis, and sometimes the hardships that we are going through, experiencing, and the storms of life are coming real strong at us during these times, the perilous times. People are going to church on quite frequently through conference calls and virtually, and to receive a word saying that they are believers. They are believers. These people are saying it. You all are saying that. You're believers. But until you take what you have been taught to the very spot where you have quit, you will never be a radical believer that you need to be for times in which we live in. Where is your faith? Get that radical faith. Get that relationship with God. Get it. Don't hold on to it when you have struggles. Have that relationship. When struggles come up and come upon you, have that relationship with God where you can talk to him. You can just let it go and put it on the altar and leave it there. Release it. Don't cover it up. Don't bury it. Don't quit. Don't even try to mess with it, because you ain't going to do nothing but make a mess. Have faith. That's what he wants you to do. Have faith and have that relationship with him. Have faith so he can restore everything to you that you rightfully deserve. That is all I have for you on this evening. I hope this message was an inspiration to you, because it inspired me and it encouraged me. I feel like he gave me this message to encourage everybody to come back to him and get that radical faith. Come back to him and get that relationship going on with him, because he misses you. He still loves you. He misses you. So in closing, I want to say thank you once again, Pastor Brenda and Pastor Nino Ackridge, at this given time. I'm going to do the closing prayer. Father God, thank you for that much needed word on this evening. Father God, let it touch hearts and minds and spirit. Father God, let everyone that get off this line not leave the same way that they got on. Father God, let the Holy Spirit be touched and to fill them with your precious spirit, Father God, in Jesus' name. Bless everybody that they will have a peaceful night's sleep and have a good rising on the day on tomorrow. In Jesus' name I pray. Amen. To God be the glory. Hallelujah. I would like to say also, on next Wednesday, every Wednesday night at 8 o'clock p.m., Restoring Souls to Christ will be back on the radio once again. That's every Wednesday night at 8 o'clock Eastern Standard Time. That's 7 o'clock Central Standard Time. So we hope to see you soon. God bless you. May heaven smile upon you. In Jesus' name, amen. Bye-bye for now.
Yeah, we're doing what we want to do.
You have been listening to the Restoring Souls Christ Radio Show, and that was your guest host, Minister Jacqueline Torian, in a great word on tonight. Amen. I'll tell you right now the energy I felt in that message on tonight, the power coming from it. Amen. I'll tell you one thing. We serve a mighty God, a God that can just speak and things happen. We just thank God for all of you again for tuning in on this evening. We pray that you join us next week, the same time, the same station, 8 p.m. Eastern Standard Time and 7 o'clock p.m. Central. And we got coming up at 9 o'clock, Man to Man Talk Back, the talk show. And we got to go in on it on the first, leading us to the first 100 days of President Joe Biden's presidency. And we want to talk about them taking down the Dr. Seuss and Pepe Le Pew versus what we saw on the national TV. I mean, you're talking about primetime TV. Talking about 6 o'clock with Carly B half closed on a pole on live TV primetime with everybody sitting home with their family. But they want to take those books down, but they enjoy watching stuff like that. We're going to hit on it tonight, boy. I'm telling you right now, ready. But anyway, once again, we thank you for tuning in and sharing this broadcast across your social media page. And we just say, God, be glory to all things. And we thank God for you, you, and you. And we love you. So meet us back here again next week. Same time, same station. Be blessed.
Will your heart and soul say